they do right now. They originally were coming to Jet Blast and Dan, so they would have Shark Steam on the front. We wanted to make a little bit more fun and light. So, some of you may know about my famous clever mother.
Here. We're having trouble with this microphone all day. They swapped it out twice. Bear with us. Anyway, I'm Dave, your hopperator. You like that? I stole that term off a young guy in Montreal who X-rated. Never know. That large white thing in the back, I call it my marshmallow.
It's obviously the most fun tour of the day. I think we also have a pretty cool crowd today. I'm sensing a lot of lovely enthusiasm, which is very good. The Harbor Hopper does run on enthusiasm, not diesel, as you might think. So we're gonna need you all to bring that enthusiasm. I'm told by our captain that this is the big splash tour, so without people in the back row, let's go. From Ontario. I am actually currently trying to finish my degree in fine arts. I am majoring in painting, which basically means that I don't have a lot of money in my bank account, but I can paint a great picture. Yeah. Has everybody here heard of starving artists? Well, I have met one.
I'm laughing on the outside, but crying on the inside.
Anyway. Now, where is everybody else from? Is anybody visiting from outside of Canada today?
Woo, where is everybody from?
Where are you guys from? You're in Canada? Liars. Liars! Amazing! Awesome! Well, welcome! I hope you guys enjoy. Is anybody else from in Canada? Yeah, mostly? Cool, whatever. That's another thing. The Harbor Hopper is very, very famous here in Halifax. There's going to be a lot of people on the street waving at us, booing us on. Please wave back, yell at them, do almost whatever you want. Anything that's legal, it's fine. I shouldn't say that, but whatever. Now that we've gotten to know each other a little bit better, it's time for me to introduce you to this lovely rig that we are on today. Now these bad boys are known as the Lark 5, which stands for the Lighter Amphibious Resupply Cargo. And the 5 standing for the 5 tons of weight that they can carry. Now they were originally commissioned by the American government during the war on Vietnam. Now you can probably imagine they did look a little bit different back in their day. They are dog vets, so they were painted in a lovely, colorful camouflage, as well as sporting a lovely, not menacing at all, shark grin on the front nose of the ship, as well as two very large 50 caliber machine guns located on either end. Street safe. I don't know. I guess. I thought we were gonna build up cars, but whatever. So we did have those bad boys removed. However, we did do some upgrades. We installed the finest leather seating that you're all sitting on today. Yeah. It makes everybody feel like we're in first class done. Yeah. Squishy. Perfect. We only have comfort in mind here in the Harbor Hopper. We also gave them a lovely paint job featuring Tibbers the Frog, our lovely mascot. Now, if you don't know, Tibbers spelled backwards is ribbons. Yeah. And from that lovely name comes a tradition here on the Harbor Hopper. Throughout the tour, during times where I think everybody's maybe falling asleep, I'm going to count down from three. When we get to one, I want everybody to yell out their loudest ribbon ribbons. And the crowd's going to do it back out sometimes as well. So, we're going to practice one. Three, two, one. Harbor today. Fast forward a couple of years past the Ice Age, This area of land was colonized by British forces led by Sir Edward Cornwallis in 1749. Now you can kind of maybe get a sense of why the British wanted this area so bad. It's basically one giant hill. Very fun to ride up a hard hopper, not very fun to walk up. That's why I get some driving around.
Hello there!
view of the entire surrounding area of the park. Of that kind of optical illusion I was talking about. Now, picture the grass in front of it being completely unkempt. Notice that the grass there. Oh well, there we go. Just slap around.
Clarifications, we need to have at least two types of You'll notice that those very large iron gates on the front do remain closed. They are only ever opened when royalty is visiting the city. And the last time they were opened was for Princess Diana. I don't know. Not to one of the...
Thank you.
Halifax.
Kills cut, yeah. It's also 100% factual, so. As we are entering the water, we're going to count down from three, and you guys know what to do on one. Give us our loudest ribbit ribbit. Yes, we are ready. Oh, they're not ready. We're ready. Halifax traffic is it.
Absolutely.
enough water. There have been a few different seal sightings this week. They like to pop their heads up, grab a breath of fresh air, and then say hi, pop back down. We have two different types of seals that you can see here in Halifax. We have the common gray seal as well as our navy seals. Yeah. This is a naval dockyard right there. Yeah. So cool. It's funny. And its deepest Franklin Harbor is about 71 meters deep. Now it remains a lovely chilling 6 degrees almost year round. Very cold.
Oh!
Okay. I hope you don't.
right-hand side, I'm sure you see those lovely, beautiful, glittering towers. Those are known as Purdy's Towers, and they are made mostly out of glass. So you can imagine that in the summertime, they would have gotten pretty hot. So because of this reason, they had to think of a new way to cool down the building. So they went to the, the engineering students, and they came up with what's known as a geothermal cooling system. So basically what that means is that these buildings suck up the extremely cold water of the harbor and actually circulate it around the building through a pipe system. Now, this keeps the building actually very cool, and is also far greener than traditional AC. Also far less expensive, so it's a win-win situation.
To offer. She is a World War II veteran as well,
known as the razzle-dazzle camouflage technique. Yes, that's its real name. I'm not making that up. This technique was actually very common aboard ships in the wars. It actually made them very, very difficult to spot and track on the horizon line. Every day we go past the beautiful yachts that are all parked here, and I always wonder to myself, how many of my one-bedroom apartments could I potentially fit on that boat? It just makes me very sad. As we turn here, you're going to look up here right hand side and see the lovely George's Island there. That George's Island is fortified. You can see that signaling base on the left there. That is Fort Charlotte, sister fort to Fort George. Now, one of our other vessels here at Ambassador Freyline, the Captain Spirit, has two tours out to George's Island.
Back into the harbor, however, Thank you.
like when you say bye to your friend in the hallway and you end up walking the exact same direction. It's like, oh, this is awkward. It's fine.
Okay, so this is Jack while we are entering back into the water point. Ever get back to the rock? Might too much on.